Hello everyone, today we are going to see third class of circuit analysis. We are going to see little bit more elaborate about the introduction. In today class we are going to see about the basic elements or components. In circuit analysis we should know what is active elements and what is passive element. This is very basic term. What is active element and what is passive element? First I will be telling the definition for active elements. If you know what is active element, then it will be very easier to identify the passive element. Active element is having the meaning of active. So what is the meaning of active? Everybody know it is to activate or it is to do some act. So the element or the components which is giving a supply energy or which is giving energy to the network, that is called active element. Or you can say in other words, which is activating the network or a circuit, we can tell it is an active element. So to a particular network, if some of the element is giving energy, if it is producing or if it is supplying energy of like current or voltage to the network, then it is known as active element. So you can remember which is activating. So what and all will be giving energy to the network? We can take example as battery and all. Battery is providing energy to the network, so that is called an active element. So passive element is just opposite, which is receiving the energy from the source, that is called passive element. Example, you can take resistor, inductor, capacitor and all, passive element, which is taking the energy from the source, that is called active and passive element. Then we are having independent and dependent sources. There are two type of sources, one is independent, another one is dependent. So independent source is a source which is not affected by any other element present in the network, or any other source, not element, sorry, any other source that is not affected. So independent sources is a source which is not affected by the changes in the connected circuit, that is called independent circuit source. Independent source, a dependent source which changes in some discrete manner. Like if you will do some changes in the current source, then it will be it means the voltage also will be changing. In this case, this voltage source is called an dependent source. So here I have given a symbol of the voltage and the current source. This voltage source is an independent source. This diamond shaped source is an dependent source. These two are voltage source, these two are current source. This is an independent current source, this is an dependent current source. This is independent, this is dependent. There are four types of dependent sources. That is voltage controlled voltage source, current controlled voltage source, voltage controlled current source, current controlled voltage current source. And in last video we have seen what is current and few more basic terms. We will be seeing what is voltage now. Voltage, it is a, we can tell it is a potential difference or potential, you can tell in any of the term. Voltage, it is the energy required to move a unit charge from one place to another, that we are telling it as a voltage, or we are telling it as a potential, or you can either define that as a potential between two points. If you consider two points are A and B, so the voltage VAB between two points A and B in electric circuit is defined as the energy needed to move a unit charge from A to B, or you can tell a work done by the electron to move from A to B. You can define in any way. So VAB is equal to dW by dQ, means work done by a charge. So dW by dQ. Also, I have given the formula for power. It is the rate of expanding or absorbing energy, which is measured in watt. So power is equal to work by time. Here I have given, next topic is resistor. To find out the resistance, so just I have given one small example of the resistor, which is having the cross sectional area of A and the length of L. Then this material is having the resistivity of rho. It is the specific resistivity of this particular material. This is the symbol of the resistor, which we will be writing in the circuit diagram. So this is the resistance R. V is the potential difference across the resistors. Then I is the current passing through the resistor. Here I have given one table of resistivity of the particular elements. So silver and all having very less resistance, which is having 10 to the power of minus 8. This is very less. The unit of the resistivity is ohm meter. We will see in next slide about how this ohm meter is coming. Then if you look at the paper, mica, glass and all, this is having high resistivity, 10 to the power of 10. So this and all insulator. Semiconductor is a little bit less comparing to the conductor. So here it is given. This and all the material, according to the resistivity, it will be used. So we have seen already silver, copper and all will be used as a conductor. So we have to see the definition of resistance. So resistance is the ability to resist the current. We have seen what is current. The movement of electron is called the current. So the ability to resist the current is known as resistance. So the formula of this resistance is rho L by A. Rho is the specific resistance, L is the length and A is the cross-sectional area of that particular conductor. So L is directly proportional to R and A is inversely proportional to R. This is specific resistivity. So here we have seen. So resistivity is known as ohm meter. Okay. So if you see the resistance of the any material which is having the cross section area of A, so A depends on A, cross sectional area A, and it is depends on its length also, which is shown in the figure. Rho is known as the resistivity of the electric material, which is measured in ohm meter. So this resistance of the material is depends on the A, which is the cross sectional area, and the length is L. So how this ohm meter is coming? If you find the rho, this A will be, R into rho will be cross multiplied, then L will be going in denominator. So you will be getting ohm meter. Ohm is the unit of the resistance, then L is the unit of the length. So area means you will be having length into length, so meter square you will be getting. For R it is the resistance unit is ohm, so ohm into meter square divided by meter, so meter will get cancelled, then you will be getting ohm meter as a unit of resistivity. Then we could see how the circuit elements are connected in series. If you will see, there are three element is connected in series. Then we can see how this voltage is calculated. If the if three elements are connected in series, it may be either resistor or it may be a inductor or it may be a capacitor. The voltage will be just added. It means the sum of the individual element voltage is equal to the equivalent voltage of this element which is connected in series. So V is the sum of individual voltages. So V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. If the elements are connected, if you want to calculate the resistance, then if it is resistor, then V is equal to I into R. This is the Ohm's law. We will be seeing what is Ohm's law in the upcoming slides. So V is equal to IR. So I into R1. If this resistor is R1, so I into R1. Instead of V1, we are just substituting I into R1. If you look at this diagram, I is passing through this element. So I is same for the entire circuit which is connected, means which the element are connected in serial. So I is direct, just passing through the circuit to the I is same. So if you are substituting I, then R1 plus I into R2 plus I into R3, then I will be common. If you take I will be common, R1 plus R2 plus R3. So if the resistors are connected in serial, you can just add the resistors. You will be getting equivalent resistance of all individual resistance. So R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, you can write. Similarly for L1, inductors, for inductors also same like that. So L equivalent, this is the inductance, individual inductance of the inductors. Similarly for the capacitors, if you will substitute this and all basic formula you might have studied in the school, V is equal to I by C, which is Q by T you will be getting, then Q by T they have taken as current I into dt. So 1 by C into I into integral of I into dt is the formula for the potential difference which is represented in the capacitor. So 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3, if you will be taking I into dt as common. So we can write this as 1 by C equivalent. So if capacitors are connected in series, then the equivalent capacitance will be 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 and up to 1 by Cn. So using this formula, we can see some two problem. Equivalent resistance of three resistors in series is 750 ohm. Two of the resistors are 40 and 410 ohm. What must be the ohmic resistance of the third resistor? So here they have told, they have given the data as three resistors in series. So there are three resistors which is connected in series, and the equivalent resistance of that three resistor is 750 ohm. Next, two of the resistors are 40 ohm and 410 ohm. So there are two resistors which is 40 ohm and another one is 410 ohm. They are asking for the third resistor value. So you have to find the third resistor resistance value. So you know the formula, if three resistors are connected in series, then the equivalent resistance formula is R1 plus R2 plus R3. So if you are writing R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3, then just substitute the value. 750 is equal to 40 plus 410 plus R3, then you have to find the R3. Just if you subtract this addition values, then you will be getting 300 ohm. Another problem is two capacitors C1 and C2 are connected in series. Two capacitors are connected in series, find the equivalence capacitance. So if two capacitors are connected in series, you know the formula, 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. So if you just substitute this, then you will be getting the equivalent capacitance. So just 1 by C equivalent equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. You want C equivalent, so just if you invert it, then you will be getting this formula. Just I am substituting C1, C2 is equal to C1 value, C2 value divided by C1 plus C2. Mu means 10 to the power of minus 6. So here I am just calculating in simple calculator because it's not a huge number, no need of scientific calculator. Numerator is 2 into 10, it is 20. So 20 divided by, if you look at the power of 10, 10 to the power of minus 6, 10 to the power of minus 6. So you can add these two number, 2 plus 10 is 12. So 20 divided by 12, if you see the answer, you are getting 1.66. So 1.66 is written as 1.67. Then here 10 to the power of minus 6 into 10 to the power of minus 6. 2 plus 10 is 12. 12 into 10 to the power of minus 6 is there. So 10 to the power of minus 6 and 10 to the power of minus 6 you can cancel. So rest of them you will be having 10 to the power of minus 6. You will be getting 1 into 6, 7 into 10 to the power of minus 6 will be the answer. So 10 to the power of minus 6 you can write with the prefix of mu. So this is your final answer. Now we have seen the elements are connected in serial. In the next video we will see how the formula will be coming for the parallel connection of the element. Thank you.